All right, so here we are. We are at Chuck Levins. I'm here with the Doc.
Good evening.
How are you? Nice to see you.
You too, as always.
It's always nice to see you.
It's nice to be seen.
It is nice to be seen, isn't it? So we have two really interesting guitars over here. You want to grab that one? And
sure.
We'll do a little show and tell before we do some riff and tell. So what do we have going on over here? We have a Strat, clearly we have a Tele, but haven't seen anything like this before. So I know there's something special going on.
Well,
tell us the story.
In honor of the 60th anniversary of our great institution, Washington Music, we got together with some of our major suppliers, and certainly Fender Musical Instruments is one of our first suppliers from back in the day, 1958 and what have you. And we wanted to do something special to commemorate it. So we wanted to make it something accessible. I mean, we deal with their custom shop, but we wanted it to be something people could actually pull it off without nuking themselves. So we started with the American Professional Series, which is their, you know, garden variety, but professional instrument. And then we wanted it to light it up so that it would be a color that was pretty unique and beautiful, and just make it pop a bit more than a normal thing, so you wouldn't see yourself driving the other way on the street every day. So we had them do it in what they call Bordeaux Metallic, which is just the richest burgundy, the richest candy red finish you'll ever see on any instrument at any price.
This is candy apple red, add a bucket of burgundy to
it. Exactly. And they've done it under several different names. The last time, a couple years ago, with this code on this color code, was called Bordeaux Metallic, and I just find it to be gorgeous. I had a Hyundai this color once. Anyway, and we wanted to do the gold anodized pick guard because it kind of popped in the gold hardware.
So normally, this is actually a metal pick guard.
Yeah, oh yeah. Like Fender used these back in the 50s, and it was good for shielding. And remember that Fender back in the day used to use whatever was commercially available.
Right.
You know, this was a budding industry. It's not like you could call Stuart McDonald and get parts. So they used what was around, and eventually when the plastics industry kind of blossomed, Leo realized that he could use this newfangled invention called, you know, plastic, and it was cheaper and it was easier to work with, and you could make it different colors and stuff, and it didn't show scratches the way these do. I have to be honest that over time these will show wear on them because the gold anodized will wear through, and it'll
sure.
be an aluminum color underneath, which is what they do. But we couldn't resist it, and we didn't want to do it. They do a pick guard that is a backsprayed clear plastic, but it just doesn't come off the same.
This is gorgeous.
Yeah, we wanted to make it pop. Also, it is Washington Music, and I don't mean to pop anybody's bubble, but this is not about the Redskins, although if you're a fan and you want to buy these for that reason, have at it. But this is just a lucky accident, I assure you. I like the color, so this is what I had them build.
Did you have any particular thing in mind? Is this like color of the store or?
No, I had to come up with something that was rich and elegant and different. And honestly, I have to be honest, my first choice was a blue that is a perfect Carroll Shelby American Racing blue, like they did the old Cobras in, and I'm talking about real Cobras. I'm old enough. Anyway, but it's not available. We tried to get them to do that color, but they can't shoot that finish where they shoot this paint because of the EPA laws in California.
Gotcha.
About vapors and stuff. So they can shoot it at the Mexican factory, but they can't shoot it at the Corona factory.
So where was this one? Is this a lacquer, like a nitro, or no?
It has one nitro coat, but it's not a full nitro finish.
Got it, okay.
This is something that they could shoot.
Got it,
so
okay.
This, I hate to say this is my second choice, but it was, but it came out gorgeous, so I'm happy with how it came out. Also, the pickups, we wanted to make it period correct, so this is what they call true vintage 59s.
Mm-hmm.
So these are very accurate 59 pickups in this, and in the Telecaster are 58. So they're very accurate to the era because we wanted to pay homage to, you know, the time when the store was first born. And as you can see, we did the matching headstocks, which
gorgeous.
Has always been a beautiful thing. I realized that matching headstocks on Teles and gold hardware on Teles is kind of, you know, not normal, and it's usually historically inaccurate, but we wanted them to match. So in case you wanted to buy the pair, well, you know what to do.
Exactly. This is a pair to be bought.
There are 30 of each in the world.
Really?
There are 30 of those and 30 of these.
And obviously, being that it says Chuck Levins on
That's
the back,
right, it does.
Apparently you have all 30.
We have sold some, but yes, these are special. They won't happen
you.
Again. I mean, I'm sure we'll come up with something for our 70th or 75th anniversary. Mm-hmm. No offense, but I will be retired by then because...
Or maybe not, because you do love your job.
Yes, I do, but I'm tired. Anyway.
Yeah. And just for those that tune in regularly that haven't already realized, this is actually Tone King colors right here.
Oh, is it?
The red and the
Again,
gold.
A lucky accident.
Which, as a collector,
yes.
You know, you're putting me in a tough place right here.
I could spin it. Well, I put you in that same place a couple of times.
Yes, you have. Yes, you have. You have my guitar pick.
Remember, it is my job to have good taste with your money.
Yeah,
that's literally my job.
So, what's the rough street price for something like this?
$14.95,
okay.
And if you buy the pair, we can fudge it a little bit. But
okay.
Yeah, they're not hatefully priced. They're priced, you know, about where you know slightly above what a normal American professional is because of the gold hardware and the matching headstock. So yeah, that's not we're not being punitive about it because that's not how we got famous. We're famous for not being punitive. You know.
And in case the camera isn't picking it up, gold input jack.
Yeah.
Gold strap buttons.
Yeah, it's full gold hardware.
Gold.
Just like
if you
ordered
gold.
It from Fender. And
yep. Gold gold screws, gold saddles, gold string tree.
String retainer, yep.
Gold
and the
neck
look,
plate.
Even under this lighting, the color is just spectacular.
Yeah,
I mean,
it is.
I hate to be this you know, proud, but it just looks good.
can I give it a go? Let's hear. See, I'm not hearing a. I'm a little buzz, but
no,
not much.
They're good old Fender pickups, but they're really good sounding Fender pickups. Of course, the Bogner Atma doesn't hurt either.
This is just what everybody wants to hear through a friend of Stratocaster is high gain through a high gain Bogner, right?
Well, anything sounds good through the Atma, but no, these are good sounding guitars.
Sounds great.
Correct. Yeah, they sound like what they're supposed to sound
Should
like.
Should we trade for a sec?
Sure.
Let me roll that down a little bit. I'm going to hand that to you. Actually, I'm handing you the wrong thing. Sorry.
There we go.
Yeah, this is definitely, you want to get the set. It's gorgeous. All right, let's bring that up a little bit more. Be tough to pick which one you want. It's almost
well,
one of those.
That's why you buy the set.
That's why.
That's how we solve those kind of problems.
Even this has the ashtray style.
Right.
This has a little bit more of a lip, though, doesn't it?
What this is this is the thing they do that's kind of a cross between it's an ashtray, old style ashtray bridge, but with a lowered lip.
Okay.
And then they put this little back piece on to hide the ugly bits.
Ah.
So this is kind of a new innovation they've got. It's actually a really cool bridge. And it's got the compensated saddles. So,
yes.
You know, when I was a kid...
Which
my
are
first
brass,
Fender,
actually. You could tell those are brass saddles.
Right, they are. And brass saddles on a Tele is... It's one of those fix-it things. Like, I'm going to go out on a limb here, and there's going to be people that will disagree with me, but I'm used to that anyway. Is that brass saddles on a Telecaster, I think it makes any Tele sound better. And when you listen to steel saddles and then you listen to brass saddles, it becomes obvious. It's just one of those smoothing effects, like what a vintage 30 does to most guitar amps. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. It just takes the rough edges and just smooths them out. So yeah, the brass saddle thing, but they do them now with the compensated saddle, so they're slightly articulated, so you have a Tele that will actually intonate, but still have the really hard coupling the way the original bridge design does. Hmm. You know, because I look, my first guitar was a Duosonic, mm-hmm. bought from Chuck down on H Street when I was a kid.
Sure.
And I was enough of a math nerd to know by looking at a Stratocaster with individual saddles with mm-hmm. different lengths, and here I was with my proud new sand beige, you know, 60-59 Duosonic, and it's got three saddles, and I'm thinking, how can you intonate two strings of different tensions over the same length? And, you know, it didn't take a math whiz to figure out that this guitar isn't going to intonate. And I lived with that for years, and I bought a second Duosonic because, look, I was just a kid, and I didn't have a lot of money. Uh-huh. But now, I guess Callahan is famous for coming up with this. Actually, Gatton, I think, did it first, where he literally just took a vice grip and grabbed the thing and just got, and it bent the screw like that and got it just right on the right angle. I don't know how many bridges he went through before he got it right, but he learned a long time ago that the old design really nailed the tone, but the intonation just wasn't there. So he figured, well, here's a way to fix it, and it's ugly, but here we go. So
it's gorgeous.
Yeah, it's a very, very cool thing. We're very happy and proud with how they came out. We hoped everyone would like them. The response has been stellar. Everybody either buys it or wishes they could, and then hopefully eventually they do. So
no, this is great.
It's a hit.
There it is. So tell me one more time, what do you call this set, the 60th anniversary
Chuck Levins?
This is
the Chuck Levins 60th anniversary Strat Tele set. And we won't hate you if you only buy one, but it's really fun. And
but you got to get both.
It'll really tick your friends off if you have them both, let's face it. And why else would you buy a guitar? Come on.
And they sound great. I mean, no effects, no reverb, nothing, and they just sound really good.
Well, you'll have to take me at my word, but many have and hopefully will in the future. But one of my very best customers for decades, I just sent him the set, and he has, shall we say, a lot of instruments, because I've been selling him nearly one a week for 30 years, so we're talking about an amount of instruments that I don't even want to. Mm-hmm. I figure his house has got to look like that last scene of Raiders of the Lost Ark, where they take the thing and put it under the Pentagon with all the crates and everything. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So he's got some stuff, and amps too. And this is his new favorite Stratocaster, and I said that's quite a compliment, mm-hmm. because I know you've got a couple of Strats.
I know
how many I've sold you. So if you're telling me this thing is the bomb, I'm very, very tickled.
Yeah. So I'm gonna give you a gift for the next sale on these. See that right there?
Yeah.
In fact, doesn't that go perfect with that guitar?
It does.
It is a...
That's a Tone King V-pick.
It's a TTK V-pick, which actually happens to be the same color. So I'm going to give you two of those.
Again, strictly an accident. Thank you.
I'm going to give you two of those. So if and when you sell, well, not if, but when you sell these, you could put those in the case.
Cool.
Okay. So there it is, Paul. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
It's
always
a fun having a chat with you. And these instruments are gorgeous right over here. So there it is. Give him a call, Chuck Levins. Phone number will be in the description below. Thank you.
Thank you.
Later.